Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. In this video, I want to talk to you about this, my wasteboard. When you're choosing a wasteboard and a clamping system, there's basically two main ways to do it. One, you can use T-track, which is what I chose to do. The other way is you can use a threaded wasteboard. Basically, I think it's about 2 inches on center, you would have holes drilled in your MDF. You would flip that over, and then you would countersink the bottom of all those holes, and you would sink some T-nuts in there. And then when you flip your wasteboard back over, you would secure it down to your work surface. Then you would have holes, again, every about 2 inches on center, be about 250 of them. And from there, you would take steel Allen head bolts, and you would run those into each individual hole, which would actually kind of look like these, even though these are just to secure my piece of MDF down to my work surface. And then you would have clamping holes all over this thing. I chose to go with T-track over the threaded wasteboard for a couple of different reasons. One, I like the versatility of the T-track. I like the fact that you can customize this any way you want. You can put these T-tracks wherever you want. I already have T-track all around my shop already. So I figured, well, why not add a little bit more here? And then also, I didn't like the idea of using a steel bolt to actually secure my material down to my work surface. If your router bit hits that steel bolt, it's gonna break your router bit, or at the very least, it's gonna dull it. And that's essentially the same thing as breaking it because you're gonna have to get a new one. So the system that I use nylon bolts and washers with my hold down clamps. And that way, if my router bit comes into contact with any of that hardware, it'll cut through it, no problem, or it'll just deflect it out of the way. You don't have to worry about any of your bits getting broken. These bits are probably in the range of 30 to 40 bucks on up. So if you can take an opportunity to save your bit, why not? I love the hardware that I chose to use with these. It's basically just a nylon bolt. See if I can get a close up there. Okay, I guess not. Just a nylon bolt with some washers here and then a wing nut. So once that is all assembled, you end up with something like this. So you've got your clamp, the bottom of your bolt there goes into your T-track, and then you can just run this in by hand, get it as tight as you want. You don't have to use an Allen wrench or any sort of external tools. The only tool you need are your fingers. So again, you would just slide this right into here, and there you go. You can use this to clamp down whatever you want. Depending on how thick your material is, if you keep your bolt to the back side of your clamp, this distance here will increase. So you can clamp something down like that. And once you get it pretty tight, you can see that's not going to go anywhere. I think it's very easy to use. Again, you don't need any sort of external tools. But this is the method I chose to go with. These bolts here, they come 2.5 inches long, and you can cut these off any length you want. You can see I already cut one of these a little bit shorter. This one's even shorter yet. So you can customize these any length you want. And again, if your router hits them, not a big deal, it's just plastic. It'll cut through that no problem. Here is an extreme close-up, but as you can see, I got my T-track and then I've got my wasteboard here. This wasteboard is 1 inch thick, which is great because that means I can resurface this, I'd say probably 4 or 5 more times. But once I get a little bit lower and I start getting closer and closer to the height of that T-track there, I am going to need to replace these boards. What's good about this system here is once I get to the point where I feel like I have taken enough off of this and I can't go any lower. I can just replace each one of these. I can cut it again. I believe it's 5 7/8 by 32. And then I can just take these out, put a new piece down, and I'm ready to go. If you have the threaded wasteboard, you're gonna have to get a larger piece of MDF, your 32 by 32, and then you're gonna have to run your file where you're drilling all the holes in it, flipping it over, sinking in another 250 T-nuts, and then flipping it back over. So to replace this is much easier than replacing your threaded wasteboard. So that's another factor to keep in play there in the back of your mind when you are deciding which one of the basic two main methods you want to go with. This is the file for these clamps I'm going to be cutting on the CNC. Out of a 12 by 12 piece of material, I can get 8 of these clamps. The thickness of Baltic birch plywood that I'm using here is 1/2 inch. You could cut these out of hardwood. You could cut these out of a lesser grade plywood as well. I just really like the way Baltic birch cuts, and I love the way it looks when it's finished with all the layers. There will be a link down in the description for this file on my Etsy page, as well as links to the nylon bolts, the nylon washers, and also the nylon wing nuts. Those will be down in the description. So once you have your complete set of hardware and clamps, you have a full router safe setup that you can clamp. And if you happen to put the clamp in the wrong spot, or you happen to set your file up wrong, it's not a big deal. The router will just plow through this wood, it'll plow through that plastic, and you will save your bits. So I'm gonna take this over to the CNC and I'm gonna run this file. File's done running. As you can see, I've got all of these cut here. I'm going to pop off this piece of waste. And there they are. You can see I've got tape in certain areas just to kind of hold them down. That way I don't have to use tabs. You guys know I can't stand doing that. So I'm going to pop these off. I'm going to need two hands for that. As you can see, the glue and tape method works very well, but there's basically the outline of one. Here's the underside. So I'm going to give these all a quick sand. I might even stain them. I might go red, maybe some mixture of red stain to kind of match my T-track, but I will sand these up, get them stained, and then I will show you guys the results. Here are the finished clamps. I'm actually pretty glad that I stained these red. I really love the way those look, especially with the T-track. But as you can see, you can just clamp them down, slide them into your T-track very easily. This setup over here on the right, I actually have a block of oak sitting behind there. That way, if you happen to have this on a sacrificial wasteboard, and let's say that wasteboard kind of carries out a little bit, you can use these blocks here to kind of prop up the back end of this. And all that'll do is just extend the distance here, and you can actually clamp something that's going to be a little bit thicker. I've also had instances where I've flipped my clamp over to increase this distance here. Again, especially if you have a sacrificial wasteboard that maybe carries out a little bit underneath your material. But there we go. These are the clamps. Very easy to use, very versatile. Drop me a comment down below. Let me know what type of wasteboard system you use and any pros and cons that you can think of. I'm open to suggestions. I thought about maybe possibly doing some sort of hybrid where maybe this middle slat here, I put the threaded T-nuts in, and then that way I could have the best of both worlds here. Maybe I could use some cam clamps. I know those are starting to become a little bit more popular, so I might integrate those into that center board there. But there we go, some pretty good looking clamps, easy to use, router safe. So until next time, take it easy.